Hello everyone, this is Spirit from MTC. I'm here to explain you some stuff about Gaia. Gaia is the artificial intelligence behind MCC, which has been designed specifically for MCC. Gaia stands for Greater Artificial Intelligence Awareness. Okay, what we should be able to do with Gaia is we should be able to throw her any type of unit, be it close air support, infantry, special forces, whatever it is. She would figure out what that unit is and she would figure out how to use that, being used either on the road or terrain preference for forest or terrain presence for urban terrain. This is exactly what I'm going to show you now, and there are a couple of ways to get Gaia active. The first one is using MCC by spawning, and the other one is groups that were already on the map, be it either placed by MCC or were already on the map by a mission that you guys loaded. And you can always give it to Gaia. Okay, this means that you give that group under Gaia control, and the other one is actually setting a variable in the group, in the editor, in the BIS editor itself. So you can use Gaia without the MCC client being active. I'm going to explain that later in the video. So I'm going to create a zone and show you the guys the basics first. Groups. Okay, we're going to send an infantry group, and it can be used in aggressive way, defensive way, and fortify way. Aggressive means that the group can attack outside the zone that you spawn it into. In this case would be zone 1. Defensive means it will only attack if there are targets within the zone. And fortify means it will search for buildings in the zone and occupy that, so you can do your close quarter battles easily. None means basically nothing. There is no artificial intelligence being used. You just throw it in a map. BIS Defense and BIS Patrol are not Gaia, only the first three. BIS Defense and BIS Patrol are basically best explained by BIS itself. It does some defending and patrolling, obviously, which are not a part of the video. So we're going to spawn them in aggressive. Let's do that. So an infantry group has been placed. You can see the G. Okay, this means Gaia controlled, and at some point a waypoint will be given by the system, and the unit will move to the terrain preference that he has been set up for. In this case, infantry. Infantry holds a high preference to check out urban areas, so he will most actively try to get to small buildings like these, or here, or any other building in the area. Well, if you would spawn special forces, they would prefer the urban terrains like the high mountains and the forest areas. So you can use that in your advantage when you're setting up missions. So let's create another group. Okay, in this case I use create. Create means I do not give it any specific behavior. I just put it on the map, just like that. As you see, there's no G in it. Okay, no G in the name, not like in Alpha 1-1. So I can click this button, and this means that I will give it to Zone 1 in aggressive mode, and I can give that to Gaia. A G stands here, and voila, at one point he will be moving. So there he goes. So here you are, all the units are nicely going and patrolling, but what you want is them to attack a certain location. Can easily be done. I'm going to click on the zone, move it, and the units will detect that the zone has been changed and moved by the mission maker. It will cancel the current orders and it will update to the new ones. We're going to wait for that to happen. There they go. And as you can see, they hold preference for urban as they are infantry guys. The other thing to understand is, here goes another infantry also going to urban. The other thing to understand is that the system holds a way to prevent units patrolling the same area all over again, or even their own location. If you would spawn 50 infantry, they would all 50 get a unique position on the map, and they will even memorize the last time a group has been there. So if a group recently has been somewhere, In this case, it would be the location where Alpha 1-1 is. If that would be part of the zone, then nobody would go there. It memorizes where groups are going and where they have recently been, and that will not be used by creating waypoints, so it will get unique and new waypoints each and every time. And that concludes the basics. So in this case, I set up a zone, and we're going to take a look on how Gaia will respond to threats. Okay. What I'm going to do is these guys are patrolling, and I will throw some units basically straight in their face, and we're going to see how the waypoints are being updated, and you will see the attacks being generated. So let's do that. Searching for the unit. There they are. Gonna put in some east guys. What will happen is you will see the markers turning white. This group has already cancelled his orders because he is in a fight. And now you can see that all the flanking orders has been given. And what has been given is that some groups that are basically in the neighborhood of here are given different flanking orders. The flanking pattern will differ all the time and also depends on terrain. As you can see, it tries to go building by building in the flanking maneuver, and in this case going to the high ground to the unit. The number of groups that will be sent depends on the number of points that are being seen. In this case, infantry is about 1 point each, and the whole attack system works by points in a conflict area. A conflict area is about the size that I now wake with my mouse button. And I can make it visible for you guys by going into debug mode. So I'm going to do that. You will not see this when you use it yourself. So we're going to wait. As you can see, the zone turns red. It means there is enemies being seen here. And the conflict area is indeed the size that I just told you guys. In this conflict area, the system calculates the number of points of enemy that are there. And it will try to conquer and beat the enemy with 3 times more units than they are holding themselves. So if they hold 20 points of infantry and the enemy holds 60 points of infantry, it will find the number of resources to get over there and beat it. How it tries to beat that, if it is outside the zone, if the conflict area would be here, it tries to beat it by 2 times the number of points found. And if it is inside, it will do 3 times the number of points found. So these guys are now being sent in. You saw them patrolling before, and then they go really slow speed. And now these guys are going in quite hasty. Okay. So that basically concludes the threat part. And there's only one thing to say. If the system figures out that enough units has been killed, they will get their orders cancelled. If there is a conflict area closer to a group, they will move over there. So the system is quite dynamic, and it is capable of dealing with changing situations. If other enemies are seen somewhere else, it will prioritize. The closer it is to the zone, the higher the priority it holds, and the more forces will be used to eliminate. Gaia hates units in her zone. Okay. That concludes the show for threat response. Hello everyone, and this is the part about the helicopters. I'm going to explain the helicopters to you guys about how to use them. Helicopters can be used for transportation and for close air support. Gaia will recognize herself if a helicopter is suitable for patrolling. Usually the transportation ones, or it is an active attack helicopter, and then it will stay at base until a close air support call has been made. So again, it can be done in 2 ways. It can be done by the 3D editor, which I have done over here already. create some helicopters, and the other one is spawning them. So I'm going to spawn a helicopter in, and I will then explain what happens. But the first thing that I will do is tell you guys about the behavior. If you use aggressive, that means that the helicopters will be operating in all the zones. Patrolling helicopters will randomly patrol all the Gaia controlled zones that are on the map. They can be anywhere. If it is defensive and you give it a specific zone, so defensive zone 3, then the unit will only go patrol that zone, or it will do close air support only if issues arise in that zone. So for now I'm gonna spawn a helicopter, in this case an Orc or whatever you guys name it. I'm horrible at the names. Spawn it in, should be here. So what does this unit do? This unit will locate for a place to land, and from there on it will basically wait until it is time to patrol, which is randomized, or it will wait until a close air support call has been made. It comes in flying, as you can see, and the Gaia system will locate a place for her to go and land, and from there on it will wait. This is not the way I prefer to put the Air Force in. My preferred way is using this, and that is the 3D editor. The nice part about it is that when the units are ready for patrol, they will go back again and land exactly here where they are right now. And the other cool part for the close air support is the same. They return to base, giving, I think, a much better feeling than a randomized landing position. So we're going to try and give them to Gaia, because currently they are not. All we do is now I set zone 3 aggressive. It doesn't really matter for them if you put it on aggressive what zone it is, because it will now operate in all the zones. The zone actually only matters if you put it on defensive. So put it into Gaia control. What will happen? You can see here, sentry, sentry. And for this ones, they just hold and wait here. The difference is they have been recognized as attack helicopters, and they are in a different way controlled than the transport helicopters by Gaia. It's all automated. Okay, so here we go. One of the helicopters has been given a patrol order, and it will basically take off and patrol. What will it patrol? It will do completely randomized waypoints from this zone to this zone to this zone to this zone, and eventually go back and land here. The other one is stationary. I have no clue when it will take off, because it is completely random. So you will get active air patrols that are completely unpredictable. So here we have the close air support, and it is waiting for an attack job, but nothing is happening. No blue forest here. So let's change that. We've got some guys here, and we're going to give them the worst thing that can happen to the infantry: a shitload of vehicles suddenly next to you. Not the nicest thing to happen. Here we go. This will be too much for them to handle, and they will probably call in the close air support. We're going to wait for that. What will happen is this sentry here will be disappear, and what will happen is they will go and attack. As soon as the attack is over, they will return to the base. Okay, and we can see that right now. The close air support has been called. One of the helicopters has been given the task to go to that area. As soon as that is done, it will go back and land here. And this concludes the explanation about the helicopters. So have fun there. You can add this, there's one thing I want to say, to any mission already available. So if you have a mission loaded up in your server, and you want to spice it up by giving the AI some close air support, do it. Okay, it will work. It will work for any AI, because the Gaia checks all the groups that know about certain enemy.